In Chicago, it's WFLD Channel 32, which leads all competition in both audience share and demographics in key fringe time periods. In Philadelphia, it's WKBS Channel 48, home of the Philadelphia 76ers and the number one kid station in town. In San Francisco, it's KBHK Channel 44, which sign on to sign off is scoring its highest audience share ever. In Boston, it's WLVI Channel 56, New England's number one independent TV station. In Detroit, it's WKBD Channel 50, one of the highest rated independents in the country. In five of the top seven markets in the U.S., it's Field Communications. Field Communications is a wholly owned subsidiary of Field Enterprises, a privately held corporation active in newsprint and paper production, publishing, real estate, and of course, electronic communications. The five Field markets reach over 10 million television households, or nearly 14% of the TV homes in the United States. Our average net weekly viewership is over 7.5 million TV households. Based on audience delivery, Field Communications is the largest independent station group in the United States. On July 1st, 1980, Field Spot Sales officially joined forces with the Katz Agency to form ITVS, Independent TV Sales. From high atop Chicago's Marina City, Field Communications first went on the air with WFLD Channel 32. It was January of 1966. And in those days, both color and UHF were new to the television audience. 7 years later, in 1972, Field Communications joined in partnership with Kaiser Broadcasting. Field acquired Kaiser's interest in August of 1977 and became the largest single independent TV station owner in the country. The Field stations continue to demonstrate an enviable rate of steady audience growth. Since 1976, Field stations have increased viewer households sign-on to sign-off by nearly 40%. Adult viewers 18 to 49 are up 52%. And from 1977 to 1980, sales revenues have increased nearly 50%. Now, the reason for this dramatic progress is a strong and lasting commitment to improve the quality of our programming. Aggressive program planning and acquisition of first-run off-network shows continue as the basis of our strong showing in the 5 to 8 p.m. family time period. MASH has outperformed the competing early news in both Chicago and Detroit. In fact, over 60% of Detroit's MASH audience doesn't even watch an early news program. Happy Days, scheduled on four of the Field stations, has dramatically increased young adult audiences in its time period. Now, in addition to the strong gains in Chicago and Detroit, women 18 to 49 at KBHK in San Francisco are up over 30%. And at WLVI in Boston, the increase is 40%. In its time period, Sanford and Son almost immediately made WFLD number one with men 18 to 49 when it premiered last year. Similarly, WKBD became number one with adults 18 to 49, and significant growth with young adult demographics was also experienced by WKBS in Philadelphia. WLVI in Boston and KBHK in San Francisco increased their male 18 to 49 audience by over 30%.
The greatest Saturday afternoon of my life down in the alleys. Oh, the pins were flying. Every time I took the ball, come up to the line, there, some guys in the back were yelling timber. Why? Because I bowled for the first time in my life a 227 game. What do you got to say to that?
I was arrested.
Archie and Edith fought their way to the top with men and women 18 to 49 when All in the Family was introduced last year on three Field stations. In Philadelphia, despite head-to-head scheduling against MASH, WKBS adult viewers increased in the time period by 45%.
I am a clapper!
The combined strength of these shows has made WFLD the number one Chicago TV station in ratings and homes from 5 to 7 p.m. and from 10 to 11 p.m., according to recent ARB figures. In Chicago, WFLD's PM Magazine has outperformed WGN's primetime movie by building strong viewer loyalty. Since its premiere in the fall of 1980, PM has held its ratings against Real People, Shogun, and even the baseball playoffs. Now that's lasting strength at 7 p.m., the threshold of prime time in Chicago. The Movie Station. That's how viewers know us in Boston, Philadelphia, San Francisco, and Detroit. Top-rated stars like Paul Newman in award-winning films like Cool Hand Luke. That builds audiences, and Field Communications continues to invest in major titles like Le Mans, starring Steve McQueen, The French Connection with Gene Hackman and Roy Scheider, Silver Streak with Richard Pryor and Jill Klaber, Love at First Bite with George Hamilton and Susan St. James.
Well, Count, what do you say to that?
I would say leave Cindy alone and find yourself a nice Jewish girl.
And while the networks are focusing on weekend sports for male audiences, field stations are attracting more 18 to 49 females with an aggressive weekend movie schedule. In San Francisco, Detroit, and Boston, field stations offer primetime news with local updates and coverage from our Washington Bureau. In addition, KBHK in San Francisco and WKBD in Detroit air expanded national and international news coverage from INN, Independent Network News. Field stations broadcast an expanded schedule of live coverage of major professional and college teams in hockey, basketball, and football. With WKBD in Detroit carrying the Red Wings, the Pistons, Notre Dame football and basketball, Michigan and Michigan State basketball. With WLVI in Boston carrying Boston College football and basketball. And with WKBS in Philadelphia carrying the 76ers for the fifth straight season, including for the first time two live home games, the 1980-81 sports schedule is awesome.
Snipets!
Field Communications' interest in the quality of kids' programming has led us to invest substantially in the production of new children's projects, and has made us a leader in this field. An example is Snipets, the Peabody Award-winning series of 60-second programs for kids. Now, since 1975, we've produced over 100 of them, with 20 new ones scheduled for production this year. We've also produced a brand new kids magazine series for 6 to 12-year-olds. Way to Go made its debut on our five stations this fall and will be syndicated in other markets in 1981. Hooray for Reading is a series of 10 one-minute programs encouraging children to read through the use of dramatic cliffhanger episodes from 10 popular children's books. Loeki the Lion has been keeping European TV audiences glued to their sets during commercial breaks. Field Communications holds the U.S. distribution rights to these lively little morsels and is airing them as commercial bumpers on all five stations. Scheduled for the fall of 1981 is a 13-part, half-hour animated all-family series from the Netherlands featuring the voice of Peter Ustinov as the lovable Doctor Snuggles.
Coming in November on Channel 44, the most amazing movies ever produced for television. Battlestar Galactica, the last hope for survival of the human race.
The field stations spend a large part of their production day creating specific program promos to motivate audience tune-in.
Battlestar Galactica, the movies, coming in November on Channel 44.
To further promote our programming, this year the five field stations plan to spend a combined total of over $2 million in newspaper, TV guide, and radio advertising. As broadcasting technology continues to evolve, so does the field station's investment in the new tools of the trade. Last year, our stations obtained brand new portable production equipment. They now have the flexibility to go anywhere to tape news, commercials, editorials, and special programs.
PM Magazine is providing Chicago viewers with a fresh look at Chicagoland people, places, and events. Hi, I'm Dirk Zimmerman, Vice President and General Manager, WFLD-TV here in Chicago. And while our PM Magazine crew is using our new field production equipment to shoot a local segment, I'd like you to meet the people back at the station who will handle your orders for PM Magazine and the rest of your business with WFLD-TV. Vince Baresi is Channel 32's General Sales Manager. Mike Dunlap is our Sales Manager. Our Traffic Manager is Sally Pilcher. Our National Traffic Coordinator is Dave Chester. Vince Baresi's Secretary and Sales Coordinator is Melanie Gehrig. Sandy Silla is Channel 32's Promotion Manager. And Doug Knight is our Program Manager.
Now let's take a look at the program schedule for 1980-81. Monday,
happy days. Our early fringe schedule starts out with Happy Days at 5, followed by Sanford and Son at 5:30. And at 6, it's MASH, starring Alan Alda, with All in the Family right behind at 6:30. PM Magazine leads in primetime at 7. Next, it's 90 minutes of fun and games as contestants compete for big cash prizes on First Run, Joker's Wild, Tic-Tac-Toe, and To Tell the Truth. At 9, it's the all-new comedy variety Don Lane Show. Kathy McFarland reports on News Scene at 9:55, and viewers stay tuned at 10 to witness the antics of the 4077th on MASH. Adult comedy continues with Benny Hill at 10:30.
Hello, I'm Bill White, Vice President and General Manager of KBHK-TV in San Francisco. This efficient and attractive new operations center provides us with the tools and motivation to project a clean and professional image on the air. But you know as well as I do that in this business, people are your greatest strength. Meet Marty Edelman, General Sales Manager. June Dung, National Sales Coordinator. Carrie Andrews, Local Sales Manager. Suzanne Toner, Promotion Manager, Tiana Morley, General Sales Manager's Secretary, Diana Minnick-Paree, Traffic Manager, and Tom Spitz, our Program Manager.
KBHK has a program schedule that works well for our viewers and for your clients. Let's take a quick look.
The Fonz and Friends take us back to those happy days at 6, and that leads to good times at 6:30. At 7, it's the game show excitement of Joker's Wild, followed by Archie and Edith on All in the Family. Hollywood's greatest stars appear five nights a week in prime time on Channel 44's 8 o'clock movie. That's News Update, followed by Independent Network News at 10, The Best of Groucho at 10:30, Twilight Zone at 11, and Night Gallery at 11:30.
Hi. I'm Steve Bell, Vice President and General Manager of WLVI-TV, Channel 56 in Boston, New England's number one independent station. I'd like you to meet some of the people here in Boston who talk to you regularly, starting with sales.
Hi, I'm Jerry Walsh, General Sales Manager.
Bob Krause, Sales Manager.
Jill Streck, Traffic Manager.
Eileen Schweitzer, National Sales Service Coordinator.
Susan Perdigo, National Continuity Coordinator.
Anita Byrne, Sales Coordinator.
And I'm Howard Stevens, Program Manager. Here are some of the exciting things that we're going to be bringing to Boston Television this season.
WLVI's strong early fringe programming begins with Happy Days at 6, followed by Good Times at 6:30 and Sanford and Son at 7. Benny Hill leads into the nightly primetime feature, the 8 o'clock movie. News Update follows the movie. Then it's an hour of Love American Style at 10, the always funny Wayne and Schuster at 11, and the Best of Groucho at 11:30 to round out our late night programming.
Hi, I'm Ken McDonough. I'm Vice President and General Manager of WKBS, Channel 48 here in Philadelphia. And on behalf of all of us, let me welcome you as members of our sales team and assure you of our continued cooperation. This TK-760 camera to my right is going to introduce you to some of the people that you'll be working with on a day-to-day basis. Our General Sales Manager, John Fignar. Our Sales Manager, Don Heller. Our Coordinator in Sales, Trudy Williams. And our Sales Assistant, Barbara Blake. Our Traffic Manager, Pat Parentosi. And our Program Manager, Joe Weber.
Thanks, Ken.
You've met some of the key people here at Channel 48. Now let's take a look at some of the highlights of Channel 48's program schedule.
Wonder Woman begins our early evening with Strength at 6 o'clock. Then it's time for Sanford and Son at 7, followed by All in the Family at 7:30. Next, it's the 8 o'clock primetime movie, Monday through Thursday, and our Friday specials, the award-winning Jacques Cousteau, followed by David Wolper Presents. Then it's the Best of Groucho at 10, the Suspense of Night Gallery at 10:30, and the winning combination of Tony Randall and Philadelphia's own Jack Klugman in The Odd Couple at 11.
Hi, I'm George Williams, General Manager of WKBD-TV 15 Detroit. While U.S. cars are getting smaller, as witnessed by this brand new Chrysler K car, hot off the line, TV 50's ratings are larger than ever before. We are far and away the number one independent station in Detroit and among the top 10 nationally. Helping to keep us that way and work closely with you are General Sales Manager George Capel, Jock Fritz, our local sales manager, Diane Desch, promotion manager, Maureen Paschke, TV 50's traffic manager, Kathy Rawlings, national sales coordinator, and Bill Castleman, our program manager.
Right now, we'd like you to take a quick look at some of our exciting programs for 1980 and 81.
Happy Days begins our early Fringe programming at 6, followed by Red Fox in Sanford and Son at 6:30. Then at 7, it's a full hour of the unique humor of MASH. It's America's favorite films Monday through Thursday on the 8 o'clock movie. Solid Gold and Jacques Cousteau are the Friday specials. News Update airs Monday through Friday at 9:55. Then at 10, it's the latest from Independent Network News, followed by Hollywood Squares at 10:30 and Prisoners Cell Block H at 11. And it's the adult humor of Benny Hill at 11:30. Field Communications is committed to its role as a leader in the independent television industry. We will continue to build station revenues through aggressive programming and by maintaining a vigorous promotion effort. More specifically, programming goals include maintaining the rapid rate of growth in the early and late fringe time periods in all field markets, expanding news coverage, continuing to search for and develop superior children's projects, and furthering the development of new programming. We are delighted to be represented by ITVS and the associated Katz regional offices. Field stations and people are ready to help you in any way we can, so together we can achieve the best sales performance in the industry.